So out of all these questions, you took 3 questions?
Radio Live, it's sponsors or advertisers.
Hey, what's up, y'all?
Yo, what's up?
Royal Urban Media in the building.
Spooky.
What's up, y'all? Welcome to Rum TV. It's your girl, Cortez.
And your boy, Chris.
And we have a special guest today. He goes by the name of Prince Chooser.
What's up, Prince?
What's up,
bro? Man? How you feeling?
I'm excited to be here.
You excited?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what's up. That's
we
are excited to have you here.
Thank you for joining the show. Thank you.
All right, y'all. Prince Chooser, y'all. He's the prince of rap. All right. We're going to be letting you guys listen to one of his tracks.
That's off the Prince of Rap 2 mixtape.
And
Prince of Rap 2 mixtape?
Yeah. It's okay, called Let's Get Away, y'all. It's one of my favorites.
Okay.
It's one of my favorites, y'all. So please stick around for that. And don't forget to stick to the end for our one last thing. But before we get into that, we want to dig a little deeper into Prince Chooser. What he like, what he don't like, how did he get started? Chris,
it's gonna be an amazing show, so let's just kick it off. Y'all
when
ready?
I say Chris, you say, yeah, what's up?
Yeah, what's up?
I'm sorry, Chris, you go ahead.
All right, Prince, so when did you first get involved into the music industry?
I would say I'm just like born with the gift, but I took it serious when I was about like 8 years old, because we had a studio in my grandma's basement.
Oh, okay. Dope.
So you've been making music since 8? Where did you start? What did you start knowing at 8 years old?
Started making beats at 8.
You started making beats.
But I was writing music at around 5-6 years old in my coloring book in the front and in the back and stuff like that.
So, are you serious?
So yeah, every time my mother used to come in the room and stuff like that, I'm coloring. And she leave, I go flip back and I write in raps. And then when I'm getting to the back of the color book, I write to the back and then go back coloring again, stuff like that. So
wow.
Undercover rapper.
Yeah, but people like,
tell me, so at 5 and 6 years old, what was your raps about? Like, you remember any of them? What was your first rap? 5 years old.
I don't remember at 5 or 6 years old. I remember one that I wrote when I was like 13. It was the most wackiest joint ever. I still remember to this day. I don't remember all of it. I remember some of it.
But the whack ones is how you critique yourself and how you get better. So tell us about it. What was that one about? How was it?
It was about me, like how I want to like take on the older guys that was doing music that was around me.
So you had like people who you felt as though was your local competition in the rap game?
Yeah, because I was always the youngest out of everybody I was surrounded by at that time.
How old are you?
I'm 27 now.
27, okay, gotcha. So what is your inspiration to make music? Where did that come from?
Well, at that time, the Hot Boys was out at that time.
Okay.
So, also, you know, growing up with my mother and father, because I'm mixed too. I'm mixed with Jamaican and Trinidadian. So okay. The Caribbean stuff, music was in me. My mother used to play Prince, the Sugar Hill Gang. It's a lot, man. It's a lot.
Do you play an instrument?
No
instruments.
No.
Do you, you work with anybody who plays an instrument?
Yeah, my uncle that's on Let's Get Away, he played all the instruments, and he played the vibraphone. And he also like TikTok famous, and y'all can look him up at Justin Vibes. He got a new song out right now.
You know what's funny? I heard about him early today. I seen the TikTok on Instagram earlier today, and I think the guy's name was Justin Vibes.
Yeah, that's
been going viral.
Yeah, he been going viral since TikTok started and everything. But his new song that dropped today, Crazy By You, Jesus Christ.
So he had a song dropped today called Crazy By You. Have you heard it?
Yeah, I heard it last night when he was on live, but when he got off of live on Instagram, I went back to like SoundCloud. I'm like, man, I'm gonna listen to this. And he know I'm gonna listen to it, so. So yeah, shout out to him too.
Shout out to your uncle. Where's he at now?
He's in LA right now. He's
yeah,
in
LA. Okay, yeah. Big ups LA.
That's where the song Let's Get Away came from.
Okay. Oh,
okay.
So like
that's my song.
So he like when he sent the beat to me, the beat probably like 3-4 years old. But we didn't work on it until I got to LA. So and he worked so fast. All I remember is you know, I'm in his room, I'm watching him work, and I step out of his room for like 30 minutes. By the time I come back, I'm not even finished eating my food. I come back, he told me, song done. I'm like, what did you do to the song? So he had everything laid back. So I was writing everything that we did in LA, but I wrote it whereas though, like I was with a female.
Gotcha. Yeah.
So, yeah. We was in North Hollywood too.
So speaking on beats, what song's beat would you most want to rap to? Not one that you've already made a song to, but if you could choose a song that's already out, maybe one that's out right now, what song would you want to rap to the most?
I would say the baby Cop Car.
Cop Car.
Yeah.
I ain't heard.
Wow.
Even though that song, when you really listen to that song, it's real violent.
No, that's Rockstar.
Oh.
Yeah, Rockstar. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay.
Rockstar. Sorry.
I thought so.
I would like to get on that because even though that song is a little violent, but the way how he worded it, mm-hmm. it's like I can do that.
You can flow like that?
You want the original Rockstar or you want the remix? You know, because he got the Black Lives Matter remix and then...
Oh, anyone that he want me on, I'm going to do it.
Okay.
Oh.
Okay.
Anyone.
Yeah.
Okay. I can dig it. Okay. So, out of your tracks, what's your favorite? You like them all?
No, I like Let's Get Away.
Hold up, that's your favorite.
That's my favorite.
You just saying it because that's my favorite.
No.
I'm just joking.
Let's get away.
Y'all
my
getting
favorite.
Me excited to hear it because I ain't heard it yet.
Oh man, you gotta hear that.
We able to play that?
Yeah, we gonna play it halfway through the show.
Yeah, Let's Get Away is my favorite because I got this song called No Homies, and the guy that's on there. His name T-Rap, mm-hmm. But he's a producer too. And rap, you probably hear him on like NBA YoungBoy beats and say like Drum Dummy, mm-hmm. right. producer. That's him.
Okay.
And when I got on that song for No Homies, I was like, man, I need another song like that. Mm-hmm. That's crazy. But one of my favorite rappers that a lot of people don't talk about, I like Kid Ink.
Okay.
I like Kid Ink too.
Yeah.
So the song with him and Chris Brown, what's that joint called?
You should know, Chris.
I forgot the name of it.
Hotel. Hold on.
When they was like they dancing, like they in a like a house party. I forgot the name of the song.
It's on the tip of my tongue.
Mm-hmm.
Hold on. That's Future. I was thinking about Pie. Hold on.
You like put party. Your hands up to the side.
Yeah.
Yeah, but
I know what you're talking about. Yeah, the name.
So
when you remind me of something.
Yeah, that's the name of it. So
better show. It's called Show Me. The song is called Show Me.
Yeah, Show Me.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how I know that.
Y'all know I'm.
It's
yo,
okay.
Yo, no homo. Big Chris Brown fan. Over
yeah, me too.
Three.
So you know when I first heard that record, I told my uncle. I said, "Yo, I wish I was on it. We need to make something like that.
You want something like that?
So that's what." Let's Get Away really, really came from.
Get Out.
Wow.
So, yeah.
Okay, now I really
that's where it really came from.
I really like the song. Like, when I heard it, I was like, yo, out of all the tracks, I had to pick that one. So
do you have any albums out? And if you do, what is your favorite album?
Right now, since I'm, like, doing music over, I would say my mixtape is my favorite project right now. Okay. The Prince of Rap 2 mixtape right
the
now.
The Prince of Rap 2.
Yeah.
The and
where can
of
we
Rap
where can
two.
We find that? Where can we listen to that?
Oh, you can all find that on all streaming platforms. All you gotta do is type in Chooser. Chooser. And Prince Chooser, that's just my, you know, my social media name, but everybody call me that, so I'll be running with it. So
okay.
It's cool.
So okay, so it's Chooser.
Yeah, a bit of a it's rebrand. Chooser. Yeah, but everybody call me Prince, or some people call me
what,
Prince Chooser.
What do you prefer?
Right. What do you like?
Oh,
what you digging the most?
Oh, it don't matter. It don't matter.
This your name, brother.
But yeah, I'm so no, used to people calling me both. So
it's good that you are able to adapt in that way.
Yeah, but I prefer people call me Chooser the most, but okay. A lot of people don't. They don't.
Chooser. Okay.
And where did Chooser come from?
Well, Chooser came from, back to what he was saying, as a kid, mm-hmm. You know, writing rap, I was trying to come up with my own word.
Okay.
And I don't know what I was writing made me come up with it. And, but when I came up with it, that wasn't like my name off the gate.
Okay.
It wasn't, because I had a lot of names I ran by. So the name I was actually born with was, my mother called me Lord Trey at the time.
Lord Trey.
Then, as I got old, I ran with Double D, and then it was AKA Chooser. And then I cut the Double D off, and it was D Chooser. And then I cut that off in middle school, and then I just went with Chooser afterwards. But Prince came from, you know, Prince of Rap. So I didn't want my social media to be Prince of Rap. I wanted to be, like, something a part of
your
what
rap
I'm
name.
Doing. And plus, I like Prince growing up.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
That's what's up.
No, that's big facts.
All right.
So, Chooser, who is the best rapper of all time?
In my opinion right now?
Yeah.
Best rapper of all time. Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord.
Who's the GOAT of the rap game
right now?
Yeah, of all time? Come on.
I would say, man, so many of them. I want to pick one?
All right. We'll
give you a top five.
Right, okay, that's a good one.
My top five, I'm going to say.
But you got to rank them in order.
All right, I'm going to say Biggie number one.
Okay.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Hold on, this is his top five? This is
he's going to respect his top five? My bad.
clearly, Biggie's not your top five.
Okay.
So, Tupac would be number two.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Number one? He said Biggie.
Biggie was number one.
Can we let him get out his top five?
Yes, all right.
Number one is Biggie. Number two is Tupac.
Number three is Nas.
Nas, okay.
Nas!
Yeah, number
four. You put Biggie before
Nas. Can we let him get...
And number four is Jay-Z. Four is Jay-Z. And for number five, that I feel like is an all-time rapper that a lot of people be overlooking, I'm going to say Kendrick Lamar.
I like him.
Five all-time?
Kendrick? Yeah.
I'm impressed.
Yeah.
Kendrick is definitely...
Oh, yeah. I love
Kendrick.
I've never heard him be put in the top five all the time, but
Kendrick Lamar.
I've never heard him be put in the top five all the time, but
better
I love
than Biggie.
Whoa, shots fired. Anyway, so you're being really rude to his top five. I'm sorry,
Mr. Prince Chooser.
It's all good. It's all good. But Prince Chooser said we got Biggie.
Yeah,
Tupac.
He did.
Nas.
I was gonna say Nas is number three.
He said Nas.
Jay-Z for number four.
Jay-Z?
Yeah.
I like Jay-Z too.
You sure?
And Kendrick Lamar number five.
Yep.
That's not a bad top five. I can't complain about that one. Since you were so quick to disrespect number one, would you like to give us your top five?
I like Tupac. I think
so. That's number one?
I wouldn't even have put Biggie in. I wouldn't put Biggie in none of that.
Wow.
Why not?
Disrespectful.
Okay. My list was longer because I was gonna say Rakim for number six.
Rakim?
Yeah.
He alright.
What? So hold on, that's cool. Oh, let me
yeah, like let me, come on.
Look, she disrespectful, ain't she?
Yeah.
I like so, Bone Thugs.
Oh my.
Yeah.
I like them. Yeah. What's wrong with that?
So Tupac.
That's hurtful.
Tupac number one, Bone Thug number two.
I like Wiz Khalifa too.
Wiz Khalifa number three. She actually like Wiz Khalifa. Oh, yeah, so that's why he in there. that's why
he Wiz on the show.
What's your favorite Wiz Khalifa song?
Look, oh my god, I got too many.
I know one you probably don't know.
Like, what?
Kleenex. You know that song?
No, rap some for me.
Oh, that's
what. Can we get you the freestyle on here?
Oh, do you freestyle? I meant to ask you that.
Yeah. Matter of fact, I was where was I?
Yo, what if he just started freestyle?
Last night, right? Last night. But y'all got to get the beat, though, because my father watching, he want me to do it. All right.
I do the beat from the intro.
No, but this is a beat that somebody requests for me to rap.
Oh, okay.
So, on my way coming to work watching y'all show, my father called me. He said, yo, can you rap on I Get Money, the 50 joint? Because my father's a big 50 fan. So
yeah,
am I.
If you got it on the phone, we can put up the microphone.
I could do that. I could do
that. That way, you'll hear it in the system. So
okay. I'll set it up for
you. Okay. Uh-oh.
So, yeah. So
I don't want to get,
We need a real producer in here for that. I'm just joking, Mr. Will, but you know I like it.
Yeah,
it's Mix Station Radio, all right?
It's still Mix Station Radio, baby.
Don't disrespect.
We know, honey. We know.
So, Tease, is that your top five? I think you only gave us three.
No, don't do that. Let's hear yours. Let's hear yours.
No, we're going to skip Jack.
Oh, really? Five being your favorite number one? Okay, that's fine. It's not about us. It's about Mr. Prince choosing.
Have you worked with any artists outside of Baltimore?
Yeah.
Can you tell us who?
One of my favorite artists that I work with outside of Baltimore, that if I had to put him, if he was a baby of these people, it would be strange, because he's a mixture of Tory Lanez, Chris Brown, and Drake. And his name is
I am 3 a.m.
Yeah, like this dude is dope.
Oh, okay. Like, I am 3 a.m.
Had to get him on the show.
Like, when I tell you this dude is dope.
Did you tell him about Royal Urban Media?
Nah, but he's seen me, you know, promoting stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But me and him, we have a song together. I think I sent it to you. We got a song called Put It Down. Oh, my goodness.
So, I need you to reach out to him. We gonna have to get connected
like,
with him.
This dude is a beast, man. So, I work with him. He's from Fort Wayne, Indiana, but he's in Atlanta right now.
Oh, wow.
And I also work with one of Boosie artists. His name, Playboy the Great.
Okay. Playboy the Great. I never heard of him.
Playboy the Great, man. When you,
Playboy the Great.
When
Playboy
you, like,
the
when
Great.
You going through something, and you like you sad, or like you got kids or whatever, your baby mom get on your nerves, and you want her back, you could put on Playboy the Great. He going to get you right.
He going to get you right.
Okay, I like the way that sounds.
They doing R&B. They
yeah, like
trap music.
Like Playboy, he's a rapper, but he's more like an R&B dude, but he can rap about everything.
So
but
singing, rapping.
Yeah, but I am 3 a.m., this dude rap like Tory Lanez, Chris Brown, and Drake all together. He rap and sing. Dang. Like, this dude is like crazy. My favorite song by him is Untitled from his EP called 3 Hours Later.
Mm.
Like,
Did he dance?
No, he don't dance, okay. But everything that I'm doing now with music, mm-hmm. and why I'm here with y'all, he's the reason for that.
Okay.
So yeah.
That's
so
shout up. Out to Big him ups too. To him. Big ups to him. Okay. COVID, has it like affected you in any way? Any progress? Like held you back? Cause we all hate it.
Yeah. It had hold me back a lot.
Okay.
So cause, all right, my boy 3 a.m. I was telling about.
Mm-hmm.
So everything I was doing with music at first. You know, I was doing the right stuff with the music, but I wasn't learning the business side till I met him. So he was getting me right and with the music. But when I met him, he cussed me out when we first met.
What?
About what? What happened?
Like how to get the music on every platform.
Mm-hmm.
So I was doing it by myself, but I was doing it wrong and I knew that. So when I hit him up, I'm like, yo, how you do this? So I try to give him my password and stuff. He like, yo, don't give me that. He like, don't give me your password. He said, who you with? I said, I'm by myself. He said, no, who your distribution? I was like, I don't have one. So he was telling me about DistroKid and stuff like that. So as he was doing that, he was telling me like, yo, you got to do this and do that and move around like this. Don't focus too much on the music. Learn about the business side. So that's why I'm here today. And stuff like that, but because of him. So.
That's what's up.
I'm gonna give him claps on it.
Okay.
So. Okay. Applause. So let me ask you this: what is your goal for your music? When you write a song and you like one of the songs that you write,
mm-hmm.
what is the goal for the song? Who are you trying to reach out to? What message are you trying to send with your music?
My message is I wanna uplift the whole entire world. And especially like younger kids, stuff like that, because we grew up in the world now, music is messing up everybody, especially women. And when I write an R&B song or whatever, or any type of song, it got a hit. It got to, when I finish writing it and when I'm listening to it, I got to tell myself, this is the goal right here. This is the green. Like, this is a hit right here. So when somebody else hear it, they like, oh, that's a hit right there, because, you know, I grew up listening to hits. So that's all I know how to make. Stuff like that. So, but for R&B music, anybody that's, you know, females that's watching that might know me or might not, when I'm writing R&B music, I tell on myself, like, type of dude I am. So, but a lot of women ain't paying attention. Stuff when I write R&B
and
songs.
And why you say that, like, do you feel like a lot of this music, like, women gravitate to what's more degrading?
Yeah, because I just told one of my friends earlier, before I got here, it's so crazy how you can make good music, but you have other music out here, bad music. I'm going to say trash music out here that's always overlooked the good music, because why is it that you can listen to, like, a Beyonce song? All the girls love Beyonce and this and that, but nobody was, like, following her footsteps. She tell you how to be dangerous in love, crazy in love, but nobody followed that trend. But now you have, like, Cardi B, the City Girls, and Meg, you know, out twerking is cool.
How you doing? How you like
that? Yeah, like, twerking is cool, and but these people making music about different routes of prostitution. You know what I mean? Prostitution is cool now. Yeah. Like, it was never cool.
It was never cool.
Boy, it's never cool.
It's
mixed station. So, yeah, it was never cool.
Let me let my audience know. Every time y'all hear him shout that out, that's his excitement for whatever my guest has said. Yeah.
So it was like, so if I write an R&B song, you know, certain females will like it. But if I perform the song, the female will like me, they won't take me home and all that type of stuff.
Okay, so on the heels of that, because we all haven't heard all of your tracks, so let's just say a typical date night looks like what for Prince Chooser, okay? We want to know.
A good date with me. I'm be honest.
We get excited.
I'm be honest. I'm a plan it like on a Monday or whatever. So by the time Friday or Saturday come, I'm going right now. I'm woofed out right now, but I'm gonna get perfect shave by Tuesday.
Okay.
I'm gonna get my hair done by Wednesday.
Oh.
By Thursday, I'm going to the car wash. So by the time I get back in the house on Thursday, I get my clothes ready and stuff like that. I'm smelling good. Put the cologne on. I got some cologne on, by the way, too.
Damn.
But by Friday come, I'm picking her up. I'm looking nice. I'm making sure she look nice, and, you know, wherever she want to go, it don't matter to me. It ain't got to be fancy or anything like that. Whatever it is, what she want to do is cool. Only thing I worry about is, you know, vibing out, enjoying each other, learning about, you know, life and about each other. That's all it's about. That's how you really vibe. Not get that bread and get that head and leave. Ain't about that.
That's crazy, because I was going to ask you, do you believe in going there on the first date?
Well, I feel like we grown and the vibe is right, yeah.
What?
Yeah.
You can't say that.
Why not?
You were just talking about the whole week.
She just wanted
the whole week.
But I feel like not like
agree with that so bad.
I did. I really did.
She thought she walked you down that ass. She just knew she had one.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, guilty.
Yeah, I feel like we grown. You know, the vibe is good. She looking good, you know. Yeah.
All right. So is she fast? Is she considered fast to you? Chris, don't be laughing. Is she considered fast to you because she has sex on that night that you looking all good, smelling all good, car looking all right?
No, No, she's not going to be considered fast. We grown.
Whoa!
But at the same time, I consider fast, whereas though if I just met her and the first day I meet her, she wouldn't go that route and she asking me for something.
Okay.
That's what consider fast. But if we, if I already know her and we vibing out, if she want me to knock her down, I'm going to do that.
No!
I'm gonna do that.
No!
I'm gonna do that, so.
Don't knock it down on the first night.
Do me a favor. Do me a favor.
What?
Talk to the mic, say period.
No. I don't want to hear that.
You heard what he said. What he said.
He did say what he said, but yeah. I want him to knock it down on the first night. Oh my, it need to be a 90-day rule. 90 days.
Come on.
Look, I ain't say you get married first. I could have said get married first, but I didn't.
So let me ask you a question.
Ask me.
And you got to be telling the truth on this one.
Ooh.
Rum TV, Rum
Real. We never had a guest that question.
If Wiz Khalifa came in here right now, right?
Please.
And, oh yeah, you already know what I'm about to say.
Nah. I'm going to say ain't enough money in the world.
What?
Right. Oh, I'm sorry. Go ahead, ask your question.
So if he came in here to do the interview and stuff like that, as much as you like him, you're gonna play cool when everybody else in here. But if y'all go on that date, he gonna get you.
No, you probably should have asked about Chris Brown. And even still, no.
See, no. Hey, but what if he want to go that route with you because he messed with the vibe and he think you look nice to him? You not?
No, you haven't met another Cortez? Probably won't. No. So, no.
Believe me when I tell you, bro.
Since I'm here, I don't think I should say this on air, but I'm going to say it.
Go ahead.
I'm going to say this.
Go ahead.
You know what's, before I found out about this station. You know, I was in your DM.
Really?
I was shooting my shot at you in the DM.
Really?
Yeah. But when I found out about this, I said, I ain't worried about her no more. I need to be here. Yeah, so. I need to be here. So.
I am not going to. You know what?
I felt.
Don't feel some kind of way. Let me give you this right here.
Y'all, he said he was in my DM. I don't remember. Okay, and that's no disrespect, but it's a lot of people in my DM that I don't.
But when I seen this, I was like, you know what? This got to stop right now. So I was kind of glad that you never replied back because we'd have been cool. We'd have been talking, but when you talk to me, y'all have felt the type of way. I'm like, then you get me on your show. Like every time we talk, I'm like, you get me on your show.
You would have felt like you could have bagged me or something. Had I gave you a little?
Yeah.
I like your honesty. I like his honesty. Wow. He said he could have begged me.
Yeah, that's what's gonna be.
No, okay. Yeah.
Matter of fact, my boy 3 AM, he's on my live right now. Shout out to him.
Shout out 3 AM.
He call in right now, 3, and the number is 1-855-493-6499.
Call in.
I just got finished talking about you, 3.
That's Rum TV, baby.
Call in right now, 3. I just got finished talking about you. You the man.
Yeah, please call in because your man said he could have bagged me.
So call in, 3.
I need to know from your standpoint what you think about that.
Yeah, 3, he's a good dude. That's my brother.
That's what's up.
So hold on, I got a question based on what you said about this date. This actually came from one of our viewers.
Oh really?
This question is, so the question is, why does the woman always have to choose the date? Do men not plan out dates anymore? On this perfect date, what would he plan, not whatever she do? Whatever she say do.
Women feel like they in control anyway.
We would like to feel like we're in control.
You can go somewhere. Oh, 3, he just asked for the number. Like, 3, I just told you. It's 1-855-493-6499. Call in, 3, right now. Come on, man. You're a good dude. I just got finished telling him that you mixed with Tory Lanez, Drake, and Chris Brown. Your music is fire, bro.
I just got finished talking about how
put it down.
He did.
You said Chris Brown?
He did the first time you
missed. Hey, call in!
Like if we had time, like afterwards, you could play our song, put it down. The way how me and him destroyed this song, oh man, it's crazy. Me and him, we got a list of songs coming.
I just do want to go back to something real quick. You said that women feel like, or they want to be in control. Mm-hmm. I will say this: some women do like to feel like they in control of some things.
Oh, I think that's from Colin.
A woman do like a man to be in control and to know what he doing and how to do it and when to do it. Okay.
Yeah. oh, We got somebody called. I think that's him.
Yeah, we got somebody on the line. Let's see who this is. You think you hear me, brother? Oh, it's a guy. It's definitely a guy.
I think that's my boy, 3 a.m. Mr. I am 3 a.m. Y'all go check him out on all music platforms as well.
Oh, he representing on the Rum TV. Okay, cool.
Yeah, he the reason why I'm here.
Chooser.
Like, yeah, he the reason why I'm here.
That's what's up.
What's up, what's up, what's up? Welcome to Rum TV. You on air with Cortez, Chris, and Chooser.
What's up, what's up? How you doing?
I'm good. How you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling good. I'm in the studio right now.
Hey, okay. Thanks for calling to our studio.
What's your question? What you got?
I didn't have a question. Y'all told me to call in. I'm confused now.
Come on. Tune, you can ask me anything. You can ask me anything. Anything you want to ask me.
All right, I got a question. Why you look like that? I know we on air, but why can't see your face?
We gonna deal with this off the air.
That was like professional, okay? He said, I like that. Yo, let me go get this strap for my man, Chooser. Y'all don't be coming at him from bad shorty.
I'm done.
So you guys have made a song together, correct?
Yeah, we had a song, Put It Down.
Yeah.
And how long did it take you guys to complete this track?
Well, it was already done.
Oh.
But he was already on the hook.
Okay.
So I already, like, you know what? I called him. I said, yo, that joint fire. I'm ready to get on it.
Okay.
But it took me about an hour to write it because, he's so talented.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like,
I
got to come with it the way how he write.
Yeah.
But we got another song called Open the Door.
Okay.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, wow.
That's crazy.
Yeah, that song's crazy.
We need to try to get that. So three, what's the likelihood that we can get these songs so we can listen to them? Well,
it's on Chooser. Chooser need to record. He need to get in the studio and put that work in.
Yeah. Matter of fact, when I leave here, I'm going to the studio tonight, three.
So you saying that Chooser is bluffing?
Oh, Chooser.
Chooser be running from these bars, man.
Oh, man, Chooser.
No, I don't be running for the bars. It's just that when three, when he gets started, this dude is, he's working fast. So, what I learned from him is that I got to get my own setup now.
Okay.
So now I'm getting my own setup so I can work how I usually work.
Okay.
I can't work like he do because it's right there in front of him.
Mm-hmm.
But the songs that we got lined up, since y'all the first one to give me my platform and give me the chance, every song that I have, I feel like is a single. I'm sending it to y'all. And most of the songs going to have 3 a.m. on it.
Go ahead, 3. He's doing it big for you, 3.
Yeah, I love 3. He's
hey, Chooser, my guy. That's my boy. I love him.
Yeah, okay.
Hey, yo, that's what's up. Hey, 3, look, before we let you go, look, we're going to get with you after the show and see if we can't book you for a show, all right? But right now, we're going to get Chooser's next song on. This is the middle of the show.
Yeah, 7:30, yep.
All right.
All right, so stay tuned, 3. Thank you so much for calling in, man. We appreciate you. We look forward to having you on the show, okay?
All right, Beth. Thank you for having me.
Absolutely. Thank you.
All right, bye-bye.
Are we still on?
Can we get that?
Hey, okay, y'all. That was Mr. 3 a.m.
Yeah. I am 3 a.m.
Yeah, my bad. But, y'all, we about to play Prince Choose. Oh, should I say Prince Choose or just Choose?
Oh, whatever.
We went
you
over this already.
Whatever
you prefer.
Chooser.
Whatever.
All right, we're about to play my man's Chooser, okay? Let's Get Away. It's one of my favorites. It's his favorite, guys.
And it's featuring my uncle that's in L.A. right now, Justin Vibes.
Justin Vibes, Uncle L.A., okay? In the building, Baltimore, we representing Mr. Wilbur. Whenever you ready, we're going to get played.
Song, Let's Get Away.
Okay.
Place with palm trees, Sunday on the beach, you can lay up till late night, so let's get away, us two, you and me, focus on our needs, if we can stay up.
nice, man. Girl, let's get away like we trying to escape. And I ain't talking about going to my place. When you feeling lonely, I'm on the way. Whenever I'm around, girl, I hope you feel safe. When it come to your love, I don't put a smile on your face. I do whatever it takes. I think about you all day, even when you standing in my face. Cause you so pretty, and I love it when you sway. When you walk away, I can smell your finger spray. We can ball out and take a vacay. Damn, matter where we stay, we can go state to state. We can pick the place, I get the bags, then we hit the runway. Both tickets say one way. Laughing at our problems while we on the plane. This is not a budget, cause I got everything we need in the safe. Choose a, Let's get away. Sundays on the beach, you can lay up till late night. So let's get away, us two, you and me. Focus on our needs, and we can stay up till daylight. Let's focus on our needs, let's talk about you and me. Spending Sunday on the beach, surrounded by palm trees. Checking out the waves and the water while you're feeling stress-free. Let your head down and feel the breeze. I'm staring at you real hard, cause you looking good for me. Girl, I wanna be the air you breathe and have you weak in your knees. I will be all you need if you follow my lead. Looking like a king and a queen, that's how it's supposed to be. I hope you got been locked in as a memory between me and you. Girl, I'm trying to make it the way. I bet you watch your mind or whatever that you see in me. Call your ex right now, tell him he ain't seeing me. Cause the way you enter me, got you feeling like we meant to be. Cause loving me is easy, believe me.
Let's get away to a place with palm trees. Sundays on the beach, you can lay up till late night. So let's get away, us two, you and me. Focus on our needs, and we can stay up till daylight.
We can stay up the day like you feel like, then do the things you like. When me and you are running till we set the mood right. Everything I do is big, nothing is like. Girl, this is real love, we ain't never fuss and fight. Long as I'm in your life, everything is alright. You gon' have fun here, then catch another flight. Got you feeling real good, saying I'm the love of your life. You was a diamond in the dirt, now I got you shining bright. Girl, you my type, wood, sugar and spice. And everything nice, you fall from a seven, baby, this ain't dice. Have you riding clean like you, skiing all nice. I can make every day feel like a weekend. That's a weekend that would never end with some late night freaking.
Let's get away to a place with palm trees. Sundays on the beach, you can lay up till late night. So let's get away, us two, you and me. Focus on our needs, and we can stay up to daylight. Let's get away to a place with palm trees. Sundays on the beach, you can lay up till late night. So let's get away.
We up, we up, we up, we up. Okay, okay.
Focus on our needs, and we can stay up to daylight.
I'm not even.
Hey, you should have put me on the track. Yes, shout out to you, Prince.
Thank you.
I'm sorry, Chooser.
Definitely.
Big ups yourself.
I can see myself rolling down the street listening to that, bro. That was actually kind of good.
That's what's
man.
Up.
I appreciate
it. I'm looking forward to listening to more of your music.
Oh, yeah, me too. I do got a question. Do you believe in ghostwriters? You believe in having somebody ghostwrite for you, or you strictly don't like that?
No.
Okay.
No.
Same here.
Look, I think everybody want to hear you freestyle, so I got the beat to I Get Money.
Yeah, my father asked me, can I do it? So I'm going to do it.
50 Cent, I Get Money?
Yeah.
I get, sorry.
So, y'all, without further ado, if you ready, I'm about to play this.
Yeah, I'm
you ready, Mr. Wilbur?
Uh-oh.
We good. It's 50. I get it, it's usually when the just finished. I'm back in the studio to handle my business. Now hater, listen, I'm what the record is missing. I flow acidic, then I come to the money.
It's okay.
Oh no,
it's okay. It's okay. It's okay. It was the first. Wait. Hold on, hold on. Are you saying you want us to run it back because you got this, or are you good?
I'm good.
Okay.
That's all my father gonna get tonight. Look, that's all you gonna get.
Cool. Look, cool, Dad, cool. That's what we got, okay? Hey, this is first time on the radio station, all right? Big ups yourself. We good. We good. We appreciate that. Yeah. Plus, Let's Get Away was pretty dope, okay?
A for effort, yo.
Of course.
A for effort. We is not mad about that.
Now, if I was at home, it's different.
When you in the comfort, man, please. Yeah. You don't got all eyes and ears on you. Of course it's like that.
Yeah, that's how I wrote Let's Get Away freestyle in my uncle's living room.
Really?
Yeah.
This is the uncle that's in L.A.?
Yeah, the one that's on Let's Get Away.
Oh, okay.
I freestyled the first verse in his living room.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So you had to remember it to write it down? Or?
No, that's what I did. But okay. When I was freestyling it, I got down to like the fourth bar. I was like, you know what? I like that. I'm going to write that down. And then I kept going over like the fourth bar over and over again. And I kept doubling the bar. And then I came up with the rest.
Mm-hmm.
And I freestyled the rest after I wrote it down.
Gotcha. Big ups yourself, because I can't freestyle. I mean, I like to rap, but I can't freestyle. I like to write.
I gotta be alone when I'm doing it. Like, yeah, that's what
I know how that
is. I got you.
Nah, man, you put on the spot.
Yeah,
I ain't good with that. So I'm happy, proud of you. If you could do anything else besides rap, what would it be?
I wanna write movies.
Really? Yeah. Oh, you a writer?
This your girl right here.
Yeah. I like to write.
Yeah, I write movies and write books.
Really?
Because when I was in middle school,
mm-hmm.
about like sixth or seventh grade,
yeah,
I wrote a whole play.
Get out.
And
that's what I'm in the middle of doing.
But the play was based off of me,
mm-hmm.
and we had like the school newspaper and stuff like that. And I was always one of them kids that got in trouble in school.
Okay.
But my principal seen it. She said, "Come here." She said, "I didn't know you gonna write so well." And stuff like that. So it made me feel good, but I still got in trouble the same hour.
It'd be like that. Yeah. That's what's up.
And I still remember the title of it. It was called Secrets of War.
Really?
Wow. Yeah.
Secrets of War. That's a good title.
Yep.
Okay, can you give us like a little bit of...
Well, Secrets of War was based on like a childhood of mine.
Okay.
You know how people be like, "Oh, I'm fighting demons and stuff like that."
Mm-hmm.
I called it Secrets of War because I was going to war with myself.
Mm-hmm.
Like getting in trouble, you know, and also, you know, I was one of them kids that grew up in a household like with my mom or whatever, but me and my mom never had a conversation in the same house until I was 15.
What?
So you can just imagine what type of stuff I was going through growing up as a kid.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
So I was always like lashing out. So when I wrote this play, I was like, yo.
It all came out.
It's pretty good.
It, yeah.
Matter of fact, that's gonna be my next mixtape too. Secrets of War.
Secrets of War. Yeah. I really like
mixtape
that.
Mixtape coming soon. Yeah.
Okay, that's
war.
What's up. Yeah. So you can see yourself writing a book.
Yeah.
Is that something we should be looking forward to?
Yeah, because when I write the book is gonna be called Secrets of War.
Okay.
So I wanna turn what Steve Harvey did with his book,
mm-hmm.
and turn it into a movie. And
dope.
Then also, by the time hopefully I get big enough, whereas though I want to work with Tyler Perry because it's gonna be a chapter book.
Everybody
too.
Won't work with this man.
I have a suggestion for you. When you say stuff, say I will.
Okay.
When,
okay.
Because what
you're doing, you have to seek it.
Yeah, come on the mic. Come on. Is we on? You're not on. Hold on, Mr. Wilbur gotta make his grand entrance.
So yeah, but like.
Roll in here.
As I always do. When you say you're going to do something, just say, "I will work." Mm-hmm. I will work
not
with.
Win. I will
not win. I will work. When I do something, I say, "I will."
I'm going to. Speak it into existence.
Because you're speaking into existence.
That's
speaking
right.
to the atmosphere. Mm-hmm. You know, I am a great man of God. I'm not a follower. I am a leader.
Amen.
Okay, so yeah. Everything that you're saying now, and this is awesome. You have to know how to speak it in.
Mm-hmm.
Speak it in. Say, you know what? I will work. If you look at what Tiffany Haddish do, she does it all the time.
Yeah.
So imagine if she could do it, we could do it too.
But some, right. And believe, understand, it's not just about saying it, believing what you're saying, because that's what's gonna, that's gonna put that cherry on top. I'm saying it, but I'm gonna have some action behind it because I believe it.
Yeah, you ever told a little white lie and you tell yourself and you tell yourself and you tell somebody else, you tell somebody else, they tell somebody, and then you end up believing,
you believe
it.
That
that's what you're doing.
Yeah,
all right,
but it's not a lie.
Yeah, but right. I got a song that's gonna like start like the soundtrack for the book. It's called War with Heaven.
War with Heaven?
So that's based on, like, my childhood. And I've been sleeping on this song for the past 6 years, and I'm like, when I finally do put it out, it's going to be crazy.
Now, I don't want to get too, like, you know, in detail about, you know, your childhood and everything like that, but what would you say is, like, your biggest obstacle? What was your biggest obstacle that you had to overcome? What can you? I'm sorry, you gotta say skip check, bro.
No.
No. My bad.
I was thinking about it.
You was like, taking that question in, huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
I think my biggest obstacle was like to overcome and get myself out of. I end up in places I wasn't supposed to be.
Okay.
And when I was being locked away as a kid, you know, I had to sit there, you know, the dorm or the room, whatever they want to call it. When I was there, I kept telling myself, like, yo, I can't live this lifestyle no more. Because if the route that I was going at that time growing up, I wouldn't even be here sitting with y'all.
Okay.
So as I was in my room or my dorm, whatever you want to call it, I was in my dorm. At that time, they had CD players. So I told my mother, I'm like, man, you got to bring my CD player and my rap book, whatever. I ain't care about clothes, whatever. So when she bought it to me, you know, by the time we had, like, this thing called recess time. So I got my headphones on, the CD player, listening to instrumental, and I'm writing down everything that I'm going to get myself out and be a better child and all that type of stuff.
Right.
And also, I was writing down, like, a list of when I get out of here, when I go back to school, what I was going to do, and I was accomplishing those goals. So when I got out of it, the thing that made me feel good, number one, I went home. That's number one. Number two, by the time I got back to school, you know, I was making an honor roll and all that type of stuff.
Yeah.
And one time I made the honor roll 3 times in one semester.
Wow.
So when the time graduation came, when I walked across the stage, I walked across the stage 6 times, getting awards and gold medals and stuff like that. And so I was feeling good, telling myself, like, you know what? I did it.
You know,
no more getting in trouble. And that was the first time that, like, I hugged my mother.
Really?
And tell her I love her and tell her I made it.
What?
Yeah. Because I was a terrible child. I was a terrible child. Like, if a couple years ago y'all brought me in here, oh, man, y'all would put me out. I was at the hook. Like,
oh, honey. Oh.
Wow.
Wow. Well, thank you for sharing that.
Yeah.
So what
advice? I'm so glad that you made it, Mellow Man.
For sure.
Yo, thank God. Praise God.
Amen.
That you was able to weather the storm and get through that.
Yeah, because I knew for a fact if I kept going, oh, I'd have been dead a long time ago.
That's what's up. So what advice would you give to someone else going through what you went through?
Well, since I have brothers and sisters now, and even with my friends, I tell them, like, yo, that ain't cool. You know,
when it's tough, believe in speaking up.
Yeah.
Okay.
I feel like if you wanna be a criminal, you better be a smart criminal. Because if you get caught, nobody to save you at the end. You still gotta defend for yourself. And it's gonna get worse. Because when you lock behind them bars or anything like that, them police ain't gonna save you. It's a place for you to feel like that.
Yeah.
And I also tell, like, my brothers and sisters and stuff like that, be yourself. And don't be scared to do what you want to do, follow your dreams, and, like, you know, keep it moving. And for my sisters, you that's watching or whatever, I always tell my sisters, if you want to date a man that's just like our father or me, because my father, he's a good man.
Okay.
So if I see my sisters with a bad dude that kind of remind me of myself a couple years ago, I'm pulling my sister to the side, like, yo, this ain't going to end well for you, you know? And then that's going to put me in a space where as though I got to go back to my old self. But I don't want that. So I've removed them from bad stuff, even with my friends, whatever.
I dig that. Yeah. I definitely dig. Big ups to you, man. Can we get a hand clap for Mr. Wilbur? Stop texting. Big ups.
I got one more question for you, Prince.
Okay.
All right. Have you worked with any artists in Baltimore?
Yeah. The only one that I work with is a girl named Carmen Louie.
From Baltimore?
Yeah.
What's her name?
Carmen Louie.
Okay.
And she remind me of myself, but it's really? Just a girl. And like the way how she rap, and she call herself the Smoking Beauty. And you know, I call myself the Prince of Rap.
Okay.
So when I was listening to her records, and I'm listening to Mars, and when I saw her, first thing I'm thinking, I'm like, I got to have her. That's the first thing I thought. But then...
You got to have her on the track, or you want her for yourself?
Both.
For yourself?
Both.
Okay.
And so, you know, when I got her on the song, I already knew that my back was against the wall trying to get her on the song. And, matter of fact, me and her have a song together right now. It's on YouTube right now, my YouTube channel.
What's the name of that?
It's, shit.
It's okay.
You good.
You wrong.
Man, I can't even think the name
of it. But
it's
on YouTube, right?
Yeah.
All right, I can.
She gonna be mad at you when she see this.
Yeah, and I've been looking for her because ever since I did the song with her,
mm-hmm.
I recorded my verse first. So,
okay.
And she rapped so good, I said, yo, I gotta come with it. So when I sent my verse and she did hers, and I try to call her, she stopped answering the phone for me.
Mm. She's probably mad about that verse. I gotta listen to the song.
What kind of flow she got? She like Trina? Nikki? Is she singing or rapping?
She's a rapper.
Woo!
A rapper. And man, like, she a thug. She a thug, you know.
Oh, Trina.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
And one of my fellow friends that passed away, RP, Scooter. You know,
rest in peace.
Me and Scooter, we went to Harbor City together, and I met him in technology class. And our teacher name was Mr. G,
mm-hmm.
and we had to write a rap for our classwork. Like I'm sitting here, he's sitting behind me, and so I went first because like when you come in the classroom, I'm the first person you see. So I went, and he went when he was rapping. So that's what became cool like that. But before he passed away, we were supposed to work together
mm-hmm.
because he never had a cell phone, all that type of stuff. And, you know, when he passed away, like, that like, hurt me real bad.
What project was y'all supposed to do together? Did y'all have it in mind? Did y'all plan that out?
We were supposed to just, like, throw records together. Like, just throw songs together.
Okay.
And that's how we always was. We always threw songs at each other, rap to each other, and the beats that I had for him that I wanted him on,
mm-hmm.
I got this song called Attachment that mm-hmm. I wanted him on. It hurt me when he passed away. I'm like, yo, I was supposed to see him again. Mm-hmm. It happened. So,
I'm sorry to hear that. Happened.
Rest in peace, Scooter.
Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that. Mm-mm-mm. Well, that's not the end, so don't worry about it. I mean, he's looking down. He's supporting mm-hmm. you, mm-hmm. you know. You can still make sure you finish that track on his behalf, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Big ups, right?
Yeah, because I got a song called Chosen, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm dressed just like him.
Mm.
I'm dressed just like him.
Okay.
So.
Paying respects.
Yeah.
Big ups to you. Okay. Well, Chooser, we just want to say thank you so much for joining us, man.
Because
we really appreciate it. You know, it was a live interview to me. We laughed. If I can laugh, then we had a good time, okay? But just let us know, let our viewers know where we can find you. Where can we hear your music? This is your time. Go ahead.
Well, you can find all my music on every platform. Just type in Chooser. And for my YouTube channel, it's Prince Chooser. And that's about it.
And Instagram too.
Oh, my Instagram, everything, all social media is Prince Chooser.
Damn.
All social media, bro. You want to look up for my music, just type in Chooser. Everything going to pop up.
That's cool, what's up. Cool, that's cool. What's up. Big ups yourself. Thanks so much again. But before you leave, we want everybody to stay tuned for our one last thing. Y'all know how we do. We get crazy a little bit. But we're not trying to get too crazy. We just want to know, how do you guys feel about the Megan and Tory situation? Or is this something that... that's not relevant anymore.
I feel like, man, y'all gonna have a lot of comments what I'm about to say.
Because I know he said
wait a minute,
that.
Wait a minute. Do y'all know what really happened?
No, but I think I got a good idea.
Okay, yeah. Can we start with that?
What do we believe happened?
Well, we heard there was arguing in the from what she said on her live. We don't care about the Kylie Jenner and all that crap. What she said was that they were in the car. She was in the back seat with her homegirl. He was in the front seat with their chauffeur, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. They got in the argument or whatever. And she got out because she don't like confrontation. And next thing you know, he pulled out the strap, shot in the foot. Because, I mean, he come up to her knee. And I'm sorry. But, yeah. So, apparently, he's saying he, you know, he still considers her a friend, even though he's facing 20 years.
That's because they were together.
They was together.
That's what I heard.
I don't see him.
It was shooting her. It wasn't. So it was not. What I heard was it was not a relationship that everybody knew about. Which most times the celebrities keeping it.
It was a relationship, but just wasn't worldwide.
Right. And so their argument had something to do with. What I heard was Tory was messing with one of the best friends.
It's always something new. Tory, why are you doing that?
So Tory was messing with one of the best friends or one of, you know, Megan homegirls. Or maybe it was before, maybe it was after. I'm not 100% sure. But that's what the altercation stemmed from. And she got out the car.
But I don't see him shot cheating her. I don't see him doing that because it's like...
Him and the best friend was fighting over the gun. I ain't hear none of that. I'm going by her live. She said she don't like confrontation. She wasn't even trying to tell the police what happened because she didn't want nothing to happen to him because he's a black man and all this other stuff, which I get that mindset. But at the same time, how you just go and bust at your girl over an argument? You know,
I don't know that
they was official neither. I feel like
they was together because I believe Tory. Because you gotta look at it like this. Number one, have you watched his live the other night?
Mm-mm.
See, he actually tell what was in detail what she didn't say.
Okay.
Now remind you, if you getting shot,
what'd he say?
If you getting shot, it was no exit wound from the bullet.
Okay.
Or anything like that. And also, for Tory to be a rapper or singer, and she's a rapper. This man ain't just come out his way and make that album for nothing.
You talking about afterwards?
Yeah, because if you listen to the album, which is a good album.
He really feels some type of way.
He feels some type of way. He get into detail about it. Why is it that, you get shot a couple days later, you talking about WAP, or you twerking, you this and that. If you was a woman, eventually, the way how she rap and stuff like that, come on, a song would have been came out by now.
Okay.
You know what I mean? She's making Tory look like a bad guy because she's popular right now.
Okay.
You know, so people is trying to get close to her and she's getting close to them so she can make more money. I feel like all this is a publicity stunt. Tory did not shoot her.
Okay.
I don't believe he shot her. And plus, why she didn't tell the police that night?
She said she wouldn't get that black man in trouble.
But guess what? She's gonna get in trouble for lying anyway. When you look at the police statement in the hospital statement, it doesn't say a bullet wound.
Really?
It don't say no bullet wound. She's been shot at all.
Oh, she said that her foot was bleeding, right? And that she didn't know. She said she didn't know.
And the stitches and all of that, though.
Yeah, but if. Right, that's just.
Well,
like,
I'm not saying it was. Like, all I said was she posted pictures of the stitches and the foot.
Okay.
But yeah, but it's just like if I shot you in your foot, right?
Don't shoot me in my foot. I'm just joking.
I'm just saying.
You ain't answer my DM. Pow.
I am delivered. Yeah, I feel like if I shot you, right?
Yeah.
You gonna have a hole in you. When I seen that picture, it's like it wasn't no exit wound. When you getting shot, it's gonna come out of you some way, somehow. That bullet, it wasn't no exit, and it's gonna wrap it.
Because when a bullet, anybody gets shot, and because it's too many nerves down.
Right.
Yeah.
It's like getting shot in the
hand.
Oh, we
gotta rap, but then yeah. The other way around it. That's why I don't believe it.
Yeah, but I don't see him shooting her. I don't believe he shot her. And because why is it that no music came out of, you know, her talking about it? And the rappers in the game, I ain't gonna say their name, but since when they ever been cool, you have rappers that want to be gangsters in the game right now. Is on the internet talking about Tory should go to jail and stuff like that. Since when rappers became snitches, but got the nerve to talk about 6ix9ine? You gotta think about that. Tory did not shoot her.
Okay.
And I'm gonna stand with Tory.
You know, I never thought about it like that.
Right.
I immediately, probably like everybody else, kind of took aback, you know, Megan. Mostly because as a female, you just feel bad for the situation when it comes out.
Yeah. But people getting shot every day. Why is it such a big deal? Because she a celebrity? Like, come on, like.
I mean, you know what?
We getting shot every day.
I don't even want to put it on like that. Like, I get what you're saying. It is a little bit of a popularity. We know about it because she's a celebrity. But that's not why I felt bad. I felt bad because she's a woman.
Right. But let me ask you something.
In a situation like that, you know.
Let me ask you something. And this is real talk. If she wasn't famous right now, right, and she got shot, you wouldn't even care. You know why? You'll feel sorry because she's a woman, but you wouldn't care because she ain't one of yours.
I was just going to say,
you feel what I'm saying?
I can't say that.
Like, if she wasn't famous, nobody would be talking about it.
That's what I'm saying. I wouldn't know about it, but because she's famous and I know her because she's famous, yeah. I feel bad about it.
And also,
I don't know her.
And also, us black people, we the biggest hypocrites because we want to turn into detectives and police officers and want to investigate, but Megan Tory shooting. But we got family members and friends that got shot. We not doing no investigation on them on the internet.
Okay.
Asking questions like that. So I look at it like this. I don't care if Meg is famous or not. I feel like this. Like, man, people get shot every day. You know what I mean? If Meg want to push an issue because she's famous and stuff like that, but I'm pretty sure she had friends or know somebody or seen somebody on the news that got shot. That's a woman. She probably felt bad, but she really didn't kill. She ain't put on internet and try to do an investigation like we do stuff like that. I don't feel sorry for her because number one, the way how she want to be a hot girl done got shot. Yeah,
she ain't thirsty.
So the horses got shot. So that's what.
The hot girls get shot.
Yeah.
The hot girl.
Yeah.
Chris won't wrap this up.
Yeah, so
I. The hot girl,
Chris.
Yeah.
The hot girl.
And I thought you ain't like hot girls, Chris.
Listen.
Y'all called
Meg is a hot girl for real. Meg is a hot girl for real.
Yeah.
I wouldn't date nobody like Meg.
Okay, and I appreciate that honesty.
Yeah, because I might get shot in my foot dealing with her.
Oh,
and like plus, I don't see myself like going out with her. Like, look how she dress,
how she carry herself.
I don't want no woman. If I'm going to date a woman that do music, and she's a rapper or whatever, I'm not dating no woman that talking about prostitution, twerking, and that she got that wop. Only person should know that she got that WAP is me.
Okay. I respect that.
I feel like if she want to talk about like that to me, she should do what Jay Nyko do to Big Sean. Jay Nyko talk about her sex life to Big Sean and her music. But she write it where, though, any woman could express it to their man.
They can feel it. Okay.
So Meg is not doing that. I would not date Meg.
Okay.
I wouldn't date Cardi B or the City Girl. I wouldn't date none of them.
And they ain't thirsty.
I look at like they got their own gender. They have like their own gender of music now. I call it stripper / prostitution music.
Okay.
That's where I call it.
But they wouldn't claim to be that though.
But wasn't Trina the one that started all that?
You know now?
Yeah.
That been the places I've been. Or it's been a
Yeah.
I was when I was five. I put that away. I knew Trina. You know now how. I'm sorry.
Let me just say this.
I can't agree or disagree with anything you just said. That's why I kind of just kept
we,
my mouth
we
shut.
Know, Chris. But we know.
What I will say is, I think it's kind of, unless you talk to them and figure out where their inspiration is. Megan, I would love to have you on the show, Cardi B, City Girls. I would love to have you on the show.
Yeah.
No, that's not why.
Why? Why? Wait, excuse
like
me,
to
why?
Have the same conversation that we're having right now with them to figure. Can I finish? Appreciate you. So I would love to have this same conversation with them so we can figure out what's their motivation for music. Why are they writing the music that they're writing? Where are the lyrics of their songs coming from? Because even though we're making this diagnosis of their music right now, I think it's a little bit unfair if we had to talk to them.
I got okay, a lot. So, okay, Meg got bars, but
no, she. Oh, she wait, got bars. Let's go. Hold up. Let's
but
hold up.
I
hold,
feel like
since we want to go there, Chris
she came in the game. I wasn't the way how she finished. Was rapping.
No,
then, she should have took it and ran with it. It changed her.
And all I'm
it
saying is, Chooser, yeah. We here, okay?
Okay.
We here. All right. You said her. What? That's news to me. Well, RIP to them. Yeah. I didn't know that. That's very sad.
Yeah, she changed, but you lose you lost two great women
major.
In your life.
Exactly.
Right?
Exactly.
You know, that should change you for the better. Not come with a demeanor or I'm a hot girl and be twerking and this and that.
Look, like, I'm just gonna say this, okay? Chris, you feeling really down right now. And I just know how you are, okay?
I don't know if you like Meg. I'm sorry.
It's okay. It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if he does or not. But listen to what I'm saying, okay? You mentioned that she got bars.
Right.
I feel like Cardi got bars too.
What?
Listen.
Oh no!
No!
Get the strap,
no.
Please.
Listen. From where Cardi came from, she was on Love and Hip Hop, right?
Okay.
And everybody talked so bad about her, like you know what I'm saying? Oh, she did, she that, blah blah. She was a little, they say she a little cuckoo, whatever. But her album that came out, I was feeling all that, okay? I'm not even going to stunt, all right? My problem comes in when you making music, knowing that young girls are going to hear it.
Uh-huh.
And it's like, it's one thing if you making something for your man. It's one thing if you making something, oh, I'm a grown woman and I'm feeling myself and this is who I am. That's fine.
Yeah.
But when you have young women coming up and then they're hearing these lyrics and they're thinking that, okay, it's okay to go out in
them.
A thong.
I blame them while I'm single.
All that.
They the reason why I'm single. That's the reason why.
So can I piggyback off that a little bit? Because I don't, again, don't disagree with what y'all saying, but I think it's a little bit more
and plus
you
got a ghostwriter too.
For what y'all saying because they don't make the music when they have their big break and when they first get started. I don't believe that they making this music with all of those things on their mind. You know what I'm saying?
But you don't think that they should have this stuff on their mind?
I'm not saying that they shouldn't, but what I'm saying is that they're children of God. Okay.
Okay. But it's one thing when you say that, but when you don't act like it. But go ahead and finish.
But do we always act like it?
No, I'm not saying always. Listen, it's one thing, Chris. No, because you said it right. All right. It's one thing, we're all human and we make mistakes. Nobody is perfect, okay? But when you reach a certain amount of people listening to you, watching you, you become sort of like you're considered like a leader. God definitely does look at you and say, okay, how did you affect these people who you came in contact or when you were teaching? What were you teaching?
But you gotta look at it like this. You got because I think I got a feeling what he was about to say.
And I understand.
And
him too.
What he was about to say, you can correct me if I'm wrong.
I like that he put that in there.
One thing, if we go back to, you know, hip-hop. If we go back to hip-hop rappers, right? We had real queens in the game.
Mm-hmm.
We had Queen Latifah. We had Lauryn Hill. We had Erykah
Badu. MC Light. Yeah.
MC Light.
Right.
You know, they was leading women in the right direction.
I'm feeling that.
But Cardi B and them is, they directing women the opposite way.
So what you saying,
but at the same time, just even though Queen Latifah and Lauryn Hill, Erykah Badu made dope music and everything, but guess what? Sex sells. So guess what? That's what they gonna do and to make their money. They know their music is nonsense, but guess what? they gotta make that income. They gotta talk about that.
Okay.
Now I would say for them to talk about it, it better be like that. Behind closed doors.
Okay.
As much as they talk about it.
Okay.
So, yeah, so I look at it.
This is a good subject, though. Yeah. I'm interested. I'm interested in this. How you feel, Kevin? Oh, go ahead.
We're going to go ahead and wrap it up, man. Thank you guys so much.
I can't.
I'm gonna just I'm not gonna say what I was about to say.
No, but look, is this Rum TV? We can't be raw if we can't be real, okay? No. So the least you could do is say what you was gonna say, because he even stepped in and say he think he knows what you were gonna say. So if you really weren't gonna say that,
I was on those lines, but I'm gonna stream it off like this. All right, so I feel like there's male rappers in the game that doing the same thing, talking about drugs and killing and the two words that F and B.
I got you. No.
I mean, how many of us love the baby? Yeah. And what is he talking about?
It's just you.
I don't even want to hear it.
And the number one song that's getting on my nerves right now is that Throat Baby song. You know how high and drunk you gotta be to come up with that?
We gonna tear down any artist for anything that they making music about, but off air we bumping that. Miss me with that.
I listen to.
So anyway, we gonna wrap up this show. Thank you guys so much for tuning in to Rum TV.
Oh, that's why Chris didn't want to say anybody, because he be bumping that. Okay. That Chris.
Hey, look, I listen to Cardi B. I listen to Megan Thee Stallion. I listen to the Baby, Money Bag Girl.
But that's the difference.
Lil Baby.
You do. So that's why you feel so way about it.
And I listen to it too.
All right, y'all. Rum TV. Thank you for tuning in. Over and out. Bye.
Thank you, Charlie.